Hi, welcome back to Pet Tunes. I'm Barbara, and today we are going to talk about basic snake care and needs. First, though, I would love to know, what do you do for your snake? Is there anything special that you do? Do pop it in the comments below after you've watched this video. We would love to know. So the first thing is the terrarium. When it comes to snakes, bigger isn't always better. In fact, some snakes can get quite stressed if they have a habitat that's too big. Also, make sure you include a place for your snake to hide. This can be as simple as a flower pot turned on its side. The idea is to have something cave-like where your pet can retreat for some privacy. You also want to consider the bedding. Now, you can use shredded newspaper as a really inexpensive option, but it is best to try to replicate where possible what your snake would be likely to find in the wild. So for example, aspen or cypress shavings, that's quite good. They don't have any odor and your snake can burrow into it, which is what snakes tend to do. So check what your breed prefers and be sure to spot check to remove any bits with droppings in because you want to keep the bedding nice and clean. There's also the temperature to consider. Now, snakes are cold-blooded, so they depend on their environment to change their body temperature. The best way to provide heat for your snake is with an under-tank heating pad on one side of the tank, not under the whole thing, as well as a spot in a different part of the tank where you have a lamp above to provide a basking spot. Some snakes require UV lights and others don't, so do ask your vet for help with your particular snake. You'll also want to monitor the temperature with several thermometers in different places, because ideally you want to have different areas of the tank vary pretty much like 5 degrees either side of your snake's ideal temperature. So for example, if your snake's ideal is 85 degrees Fahrenheit, one area might be a bit warmer at 87, another could be just under at 82 to 84, and yet another area at 71 to 75. This way, your snake can regulate its body temperature just by moving around the tank. You'll also need to get what's called a hygrometer. A hygrometer measures humidity, and humidity is very important for your snake. This is what they're used to in the wild, and in particular, when they're shedding their skin, they need a bit extra humidity. So some things you can do is you can mist the tank, you can add some additional water dishes, or some moistened moss if you like. Snakes are carnivores and they eat their prey whole, bones and all. Many snakes will eat rodents, such as mice or rats. Other snakes eat amphibians, and tiny snakes could live on insects. Many snakes will eat dead prey, so you can keep a small separate freezer for your prey items. Some pet stores can provide you with frozen packages of mice, for example, which you then thaw before feeding to your pet. Now, if you're not sure what size prey to get, a basic rule of thumb is prey that is about the same size around the middle as your snake. If your snake won't eat dead prey, you could try like wiggling it around a little bit to make it move, or you could put a piece of fabric over the top of the tank to provide some privacy. That sometimes works too. Now, if neither of these work, you may need to feed your snake live prey. And if you do this, be sure to stay and watch because it's very dangerous to leave a rodent unattended with your snake because the mouse or rat could panic and perhaps hurt your snake with its claws or teeth. Snakes are pretty efficient though. They kill their prey very quickly. So if you do have to feed your pet live prey, hopefully it won't be too traumatic for you. It is nature at work after all. So what are your thoughts on snakes and looking after them? Do you feed your snake live prey? Do you believe that's very important? Would you rather feed it frozen prey? How do you feel about it? Just pop it in the comments below. We would love to know. And if you've enjoyed this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It helps the channel a lot. And if you haven't yet subscribed, you can do that by clicking on the middle button. And while you're there, you can hop on over to the button on the far side to check out one of our previous vlog videos. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you very soon in the next video. Bye for now.